If you are afraid of crocodiles and you need to go out into a crocodile-infested area, here in southern Africa, we say that you need to smother yourself first in this plant. This is Lippia javanica, known locally as Zumbani, called the fever tea, or sometimes the lemonbush tea, because obviously it's drunk as a tea. And a very intensely aromatic plant, really, really beautiful smell. Being a technological immigrant, I often think that technology should be more capable than it really is. One thing I often believe that technology surely should be able to do is to transmit smell digitally. It turns out it can't, which is a great shame because it means I can't give this to you to sniff right now. So you're just going to have to imagine. But it's a very, very fragrant, lemony kind of a smell. And that's not really surprising because Lippia javanica is in the same family as lemon verbena. Verbena family. In fact, the name for lemon verbena used to be Lippia citriodora. It's now changed to verbena, but that's another whole taxonomic story, which I'm not going to go into now. But never mind. The important part is this plant, fever tea, it's part of that family and very, very, very well known as a general tonic health pick-me-up in this part of the world. In fact, last week I was traveling, 2 weeks ago I was in Europe, and when I came back I was kind of sick. I think I'd picked up some nasty bug from, you know, airplanes, how it happens. And it was me going from summer here in the southern hemisphere to winter in the northern hemisphere. So when I came back feeling grim, this was the plant that I turned to. And really easy, you just take the leaves basically and put them in hot water, just steep them to make an infusion and drink it. And it really does genuinely strengthen you in many ways. I love it. So the fever tea or the lemon bush plant is a shrub about 1 to 2 meters high, very common through East, Central and Southern Africa, and very widely known for its medicinal properties. Really interestingly, in the 1990s, the South African government started a high throughput screening program of all plants in South Africa, the 21,000 species in South Africa. And they were looking for the cure for cancer, the cure for HIV, you know, a real big win. They got down one kind of blind alley with a anti-obesity plant called Hygiene, Hygiene Gordoni. That's a whole nother quite controversial story, which I'm not going to go into now. And then the one plant that they really picked up on that they thought had a wide range of potential applications was, guess what, this one, Lippia javanica. And so they invested in it, and they were particularly interested in the insect repellent properties of this. So that is a traditional use of it. You put it around the outside of your house, you rub the leaves into your skin, you make an infusion. There's so many different ways that you can apply it to repel insects. And it is well known, just as lemongrass is also used for the same purpose. And in fact, it is some of the compounds in the essential oil that comes from this plant that are responsible for that repellent activity. And I will talk about those in another episode. For now, I'm just going to focus on the other traditional uses. So traditionally, this is used as a remedy for high temperatures, as an analgesic. And hence the name fever tea. When you got a fever, this is the plant you go to. It's also well known to treat insect bites, in fact, and lesions, scabies, ringworm, all kinds of insect-related infestations of the skin, or parasitic infections of the skin. And the way it's done there is the leaves are dried and then powdered and then mixed into some kind of carrying agent, sort of basal cream or traditionally often animal fat, and then rubbed onto the skin. A very simple, effective way of sort of mode of action of applying a medicinal plant topically. The also, again, similar to the resurrection bush, which I recently talked about, this is another plant that is, with the resurrection is also drunk as a tea, by the way, but this is another plant where if you have a chest complaint, burning the leaves and inhaling the smoke, traditionally, will help to solve your chest, to clear your chest. And in fact, again, and I will talk about this in another episode, there are compounds in there, in the volatile compounds in there, terpenes that are known to have expectorant properties. So again, that's not really surprising. Traditional knowledge backed up by science. So one of the things that people are working on at the moment is to take this plant, which is so well known in Southern Africa, through the regulatory processes that would allow it to be sold as a herbal tea in Europe and in North America and in other countries in the world. So currently it hasn't been through that process, which means it's not technically legal to sell it in, let's say, in the EU, which is a great shame. It's kind of nice because it's our secret. But this is a plant that I really very strongly believe needs to be shared with the rest of the world. And so one of my projects in the next couple of years is to try and take it through that process. It's not that hard. What we have to do is to be able to demonstrate that there are no adverse toxicological effects associated with this. And then hopefully it will be available. I would love to see this Zumbani being sold around the world because it is, I think it's an absolutely phenomenal plant. By the way, I'm standing here, this is in my garden at home. This is, I use this all the time. This exact shrub is where I was getting the tea from last week when I wasn't feeling so good myself. So yeah, so that's it. I'm going to come back with another episode to go into the volatile compounds, particularly the terpenes, which are, I think, amazing, fascinating. A lot of crossovers with cannabis, by the way. So a lot of the compounds that are found here also found in cannabis, which is really interesting. But for now, I'm just going to leave you with a little image of this. I wish I could share the smell with you. I'm just going to have to enjoy it by myself. All right, guys, it's been great talking to you. I will catch you again soon. Take it easy. Bye.